Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I'm here to talk to you about 8 of the most overplayed songs in guitar stores. Now I'm going to start on a bit of a somber note, a bit of a sad one really. I can't remember the last time I heard Stairway to Heaven played in a guitar store. I know, right, it is ridiculous, but there is just a new age of guitar players coming up, and unfortunately the first things they listen to isn't their dad's Led Zeppelin records or their older brother's or sister's Led Zeppelin records. It's not really a thing anymore. I mean, granted, you do still hear lots of Led Zeppelin, but it's never overplayed as it used to be, as Wayne's World suggested. So in this video, I'll be showing you 8 current overplayed songs. Now, obviously, a couple of golden oldies have snuck their way into this list because they are timeless and awesome. Not the Stairway to Heaven isn't timeless and awesome, just these ones are currently still overplayed. I mean, I love it. It's just a bit of a shame, you know. I've worked in a guitar store for years now, and I would love to hear someone bash out Unchained by Van Halen, or Paranoid, or Night Train, the intro to Night Train. But it's not really a thing anymore. Guitar playing has moved on into the modern generation, and there's a new generation of guitar players, and they love playing these songs. Now, obvious as always with these style of videos, this is all just a bit of tongue-in-cheek, okay? If you enjoy rocking these songs because you've spent hours practicing them, totally play them in guitar stores. What a lot of people don't realize is, I was the same. I was terrified of playing guitar in music stores. I was like, all right, let's test the guitar out. I can remember an A, that's all I can remember. I'll take the guitar. Working on the shop floor in a guitar store, you hear guitar from the moment you start work till the moment you end work. You could be amazing and trying to show off to all the guitar staff, we wouldn't care. You could be just a beginner and starting out thinking your playing was kind of crap, literally don't care. Music is music, we all love this and we're all in this together, so it's just a little bit of fun. There'll be 5 overplayed songs on guitar and 3 on bass. Now I'm only going to be playing electric tunes in this video, no acoustic. That's a whole video in itself. So much Oasis, I'm dreading that. There's gonna be so much Oasis. Anyways, back to this video. Guitar-wise, I'm playing this glorious Kramer Beretta in Ruby Red, because look at it, why the devil wouldn't you want to play it? 2 Tech cables into the Blackstar HT Stage 100 Watt Mark II head with a matching cab. Bass-wise, I'm using the Ampeg BA108 and a Gibson Thunderbird. Now, you might be watching this thinking, Dagan, that guitar isn't very versatile for demoing lots of different variants of songs, and that's exactly why I've chosen it. It doesn't matter what style, shape, or size guitar you play in a music store, a baritone, a semi-hollow, a metal guitar, these overplayed songs will get played on all of them, especially this first one. Dancing in a Burning Room by Mr. John Mayer. Personally, I'm a huge John Mayer fan. I hold him in such high regard. The dude is amazing, one hell of a player, great songwriter, and he can manage to get blues tunes on the radio. It's crackers, and I do believe that Slow Dancing in a Burning Room is a perfect song. From start to finish, every single bit is amazing. The riff, the melody, the solo, all fantastic. Which is why it's played every single day in a music store on numerous instruments. Kramers, Stratocasters, SGs, Les Pauls, basses, every single person will rock at least 3 times a day. And there's nothing wrong with that. Like I said at the start, we hear music from when we get to work to when we leave work, so it just goes straight over our heads, whether you play it perfectly like John in position 4 of a Stratocaster, or you absolutely fluff it because you've just learned it. Doesn't matter to us, but we hear it every single day. And it kind of deters from the song itself at the weekend. I might skip it on the car radio, but it's a great song, and kudos to the folk out there who are learning it, because it's a great riff to play, especially when you want to up your finger picking chops. Do I Want to Know by the Arctic Monkeys. And it's a cool riff. It's a very cool riff. I'm as much of a fan of the Arctic Monkeys as your regular Joe. Not a huge fan, I don't think they're crap. They've got some amazing tunes, and I'm in a cover band where I play I Bet That You Look Good on the Dance Floor every single night. That's one hell of a riff though. Do You Wanna Know was the first kind of guitar riff that I'd heard on the radio for a long time. It's the kind of riff when you go, I wanna play that, that sounds cool. There's only a couple of notes in it, it's not a hard thing to play, and it sounds really cool. Because it's really easy to play and sounds really cool, every day in a music store, we hear those same notes. Whether they play the rest of it or not, same with slow dancing with just the little slide intro, the same thing every single day. Kind of vibrato ruins it a little bit. I think the whole point of the riff is to be static, in your face, almost like MIDI-ish. It's one hell of a riff to play, and it's overplayed to hell and back in music stores. Now those are two modern songs, and I did say there was a couple of golden oldies in this list. We might not get Sweet Child of Mine every day, but we certainly get... A bit of the old Crazy Train by Ozzy Osbourne. Mr. Randy Rhoads was an absolute icon. He changed the guitar playing landscape, and Blizzard of Oz is one hell of an album. And it's got to be one hell of an album because that is played every single day. I remember it took me years to learn that as a kid because my pinky had no strength in it, but kids these days are picking it up like nothing else. Can't Stop by the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Now, John Frusciante is a beast, everybody knows this, but he's got a very unique Stratocaster honky sound. And as soon as you rock into a guitar store and pick a Strat off the wall and hear that bridge pickup, well, Stratocaster honk, it immediately makes you want to play Can't Stop. It's a great riff, but overplayed to hell and back in guitar stores. When you find a good Strat and that tone, that is immediately the first thing that comes out of your fingers. Now this last guitar one is 3-in-1, okay? Because it's the one string warriors, the guys just starting out who learn a riff and play it to hell and back in guitar stores. Now there's a few different riffs you can play. The most popular is one of my favorite riffs of all time. It was originally created by the chap trying to write his own Bond theme when he was 16 years old and eventually ended up writing a Bond theme with Alicia Keys. It's this. Now the song is in, the guitar is tuned to A on the actual song, but you can play it on one note. Obviously, when you're just starting out, most folk play it on the low string. But it's actually the 7th fret of the A string. Seven Nation Army by the White Stripes. It's an iconic song. It's played in sports stadiums. It was played at the Olympics, and it's played in your local pub on a Friday night by the cover band. Super easy song to play, and that's why it's a lot of guitar players' first song. That has kind of overtaken as a first song, because you're more likely to hear Seven Nation Army these days than you are Smoke on the Water, which is unfortunate, but it's still a great riff. With that, another one string warrior song. I love Iron Man. Love Iron Man by Black Sabbath. Iommi is one of my guitar heroes, and one hell of a riff, isn't it? But if you're just starting out and you want that tone, it's easier to play with one finger on the low E string. A And that gets you there. That gets you sounding like one of your guitar heroes. And finally, the other one string wonder, which is actually tuned to drop D, but no one ever plays it in drop D. And I'm playing this right now because someone downstairs has literally just played it. And I was like, I can include that in my list. And that's Psycho by Muse. That is played a lot. Muse are an awesome band that have lots of very intricate riffs. But if you want to rock a Muse riff, just give it some of this. That last bit isn't usually played, and it's like I say, it's usually played in drop D, but that's a lot of fun on one string with one finger. So those are the main overplayed tunes in guitar stores currently at the minute, which is the end of 2020. Loads of classics have been missed out, obviously, but you rarely hear them in guitar stores these days. Let's have some honourable mentions, like they do at the Oscars when they pay tribute to actors and actresses that have passed that year. Let's pay tribute to riffs of guitar stores past. Rock up to your local PMT store and play some of those riffs, because you won't be like, oh, they're always playing those AC/DC riffs. It's like some old school rock and roll. Play it loud. That Tool riff. Now, it took me a while to realise that was a Tool riff, because I'm not a big fan of Tool. My girlfriend is a huge fan of Tool, and she keeps trying to get me to listen to them, but the time signatures mess with my head. And I've heard that riff in this guitar store for years, and I was like, that's a damn cool bass riff. That's a really cool bass riff. And in the car one day, it came on, I was like, what's this bass riff? Turns out it's Tool. Schism, however it's pronounced. It's off the album Lazarus, and I'm not a Tool fan, but the bass playing from Tool, Justin he's called, is phenomenal. I mean, there's a reason they're so famous and so good. It's because they're a great band, but the bass playing, wow. And that is one hell of a bass riff, and it's not too hard to learn. And if you know a Tool song, other guitarists, musos, and bass players will go, oh, he knows what he's doing. He knows how to play in 7/18/4 or whatever crazy time signature that song's in. But it's such a cool bass riff. Next up is less proggy and less, it's harder for me to play because I'm not a bass player, and it's this. I can't slap and pop, but it's Higher Ground by the Red Hot Chili Peppers. All the bass players are now losing their minds because I'm using a pick with it, but it's the only way I can get it to sound good to my ears. Higher Ground, it's one of the first kind of slappy and poppy bass riffs people learn, because the Chili Peppers are very, very pop. This is the second Chili Peppers song on this list. The Chili Peppers are very overplayed in guitar stores because they're rightly awesome and their songs are very fun to play, hence why people pick them up. But yeah, Higher Ground by the Chili Peppers, Mr. Flea is a poppin' and tappin' machine, and it's a great riff. And you guys can play it better than me. Now, lastly on this list is another golden oldie, which has never ever left guitar stores. And it's an iconic riff, either from Formula One, or if you're a fan of Fleetwood Mac like myself. And everyone knows this bass riff, everyone knows what it is, and it's legendary. It's The Chain by Fleetwood Mac. John McVie is one hell of a bass player, and the chain, the bridge in The Chain, well, Yeah, the bridge, the bit in the middle of the chain is phenomenal, and that little riff is so iconic. But it's very easy to play, hence why every day in a music store, if you see someone pick up a bass, young or old, experienced or inexperienced, they'll be like... And everyone will go, he's playing the riff. He's playing the riff from the Formula One, or he's playing Fleetwood Mac, the chain. So I think that's it, ladies and gents. Five electric guitar and three bass overplayed songs from guitar stores. Now this is just what I've collected over the years. There's loads of songs and we all just enjoy playing music, so it doesn't actually bug guitar staff that much. It's not like Wayne's World, like I said at the start, but I do miss Stairway to Heaven. Can't remember the last time it was played. I was telling the lads downstairs as well, and they all got together before and played Stairway to Heaven for me while I was recording this, and I had to cut this video short. But yeah, this has just been a bit of fun, and if you're watching this thinking, that's a cool riff, no wonder everyone plays that, learn it because they're all fun to play, and if you're a bass player, learn the proper pop and flick, whatever it's called again, on bass to play Higher Ground by the Chili Peppers, because it's mint. And if you want to add any down below, please comment so I can add it on maybe the second edition or maybe the acoustic edition of Overplayed Guitar Store Tunes. And yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any of the products I've chatted about in this video, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever-expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'm going to play that Tool riff again because it's great. See you later!